Hi everyone, Cristi here. Today I have a treat for you, and it's one of those things that I always struggled with until I came up with a solution in Camtasia, the alignment and distribution of assets on the screen. So Camtasia doesn't come with any sort of grids or guides or anything to help you arrange items on your screen. So if you're using a 16 by 9 or a 4K screen or whatever, and you need to kind of maybe put some bullet points on the screen, or maybe you want to know what the safe margins are, or where should you put information so that it's nicely displayed and it doesn't get into the way of something else, or it's not too close to the edges, or the distance is equal, and all of those design decisions that you need to make. So it's quite frustrating sometimes when I have some videos that I edit and then I have to maybe show 5 bullet points on the screen. Well, I have to start from scratch every time. I have to create one bullet point and then duplicate that and make sure I have some kind of a distancer between them so that I know exactly where they sit. So it's very frustrating when that is a very hard thing, and it just gets you out of the groove. When I'm editing videos, I'm like, oh, now I need to stop and align things properly and create a bunch of lines to help me guide. So I came up with a solution for this, and I'm just going to show you today what I created, and I hope you like it. And if you need it, there's a link in the description to get it for yourself, or you can do it the way that I built it if you want to build them yourself. So I created my own grids and guides for Camtasia. So let me show you in this project just what I mean. So I have this project, I am here on the screen, and I don't really like to be in the middle of the screen. Maybe I want to be on to the side because that's a bit more natural, and it's, you know, the eye kind of gets drawn to that person on the screen. So normally you would not want to have like a speaker on the middle of the screen unless you're like a news anchor or something. But anyway, you know, usually the people recommend that you place, you know, things in thirds. So what is that thirds? The thirds rule is like you divide the screen into three, vertically and horizontally. And in photography as well, you have the thirds. So you can actually use like your eyeball it. You just approximate where you need to be. But what if you had a nice grid to show that? So let me show you. This is what I did. I have in my library a grid called 3x3. This is my thirds. I drag it on my timeline down here, and you can see here I have the grid. So now I can actually align myself right there where the thirds are, and then I can turn that off, and there you go. Very nice arrangement on screen. Now, what if I want to put on the screen like a lower thirds, create a lower thirds on the bottom left of the screen, for example? Lower thirds again, it needs to be in the lower third of the screen. Obviously it's in the name. So I turn on this grid, but how do I know what the safe margins are? And you know, in video editing, safe margins, they are just a portion around the screen where you should try not to put any important content because it may be cropped maybe, or in different screen formats or whatever, more used in television, I suppose, but you have the safe margins. So they are some, you know, industry standard, whatever margins that you need to stay away from. So I created that one too. So safe margins, I just bring that into my project down here again on the timeline. There you go. If I turn off the lower third grid, I have the safe margins now. So you notice my head is staying inside of that R area. If I'm displaying any logos, for example, so if I have a logo that I want to put on the corner here, I can maybe go to my library and bring in my logo here like this, avatar transparent. And I know that I need to place it right here in the corner, just staying away from those margins. Don't place elements too close to the margins. That is usually one of those things that when you have experience and you look at a video, you watch a video or a design or a graphic or something, and then, you know, things are not spaced evenly or they're not spaced properly, you know, just have enough room around them, that becomes a bit, you know, like, ah, this is very groaning, it's painful. But if you have your safe margins, you know not to go into that corner too close to the edges. And for the lower thirds, because I mentioned that, if I'm creating a lower thirds, obviously I need to stay within these safe margins. So there's different safe margins for wide screens, which is the green one here that you see, the first one, the outside, and then there's 4x3 margins, which is the other area here. So if you expect your video to maybe play on a 4x3 screen without the black margins around it, you will want to place content in here. And you see this usually on news shows where they put the time and the news tickers maybe, and the name of people just inside this 4x3 area. Although there's more room on the 16x9 screen, there's more room on there, but sometimes that may not fit on certain screens. So they keep the safe margins, you know, take those into consideration. So if I want to do a lower thirds here, again, I need to stay away from this margin right here, but I also need to stay in the lower thirds. So I'm just going to go and create a proof of concept lower thirds kind of thing. So I'm just going to bring that in here and make sure I stay in that corner right there. And also, if I enable the grid, you see I have all this space here to stay within that. So that's my lower thirds down here, perfectly placed in the corner. The logo is here. And look, when you turn these things off, everything is nice and pleasantly aligned because you have had those lines, you know. And these grids that I created, I actually created more grids like this. So if I go back, guides and grids library, you can download this, by the way, and you add it to your own library. And you bring in, let's suppose that I want to add on screen 5 bullet points. So that's the most painful thing for me. Usually when I have to do bullet points, I have to go to annotations and put this text in here and make sure I have enough room and align it and all that stuff. Okay, so you design your bullet point. Let's suppose this is a bold one and I'm just going to use 550 here. And there you go. So that's one bullet point, right? But look at this. I mean, how am I going to align this? But check this out. If I bring in, let me just take these out for a second. So if I want to put these 5 bullet points on screen, right? If I make a copy of this, copy and paste it, and yes, you can align it horizontally using the Camtasia snapping on the canvas, which you can turn on by going to view and you turn on enable canvas snapping. So that enables you to kind of snap onto other objects. And you can see here, these objects, these bullet points, they have the same size. So they obviously match. If I make one smaller, that, you know, you can still sort of align it on the left. But what about distancing them equally? So I can kind of make copy and paste, you know, kind of approximate the distancing between them. And I'll probably be pretty accurate in here. So let's suppose 5 bullet points. But if I look at them, I don't like them. They're not evenly spaced. And there is no alignment tool in Camtasia to say, or distribute tool. So if I select all of them, there is nothing in the menus to actually align things, at least not to my knowledge anyway. I haven't encountered any of that stuff. But check this out. I'm going to bring in from my library my 10x10 grid, for example. Place this on your timeline. And usually what you want to do is you want to have this on the topmost track. So this is on the topmost track. And now you notice that my bullet points are nowhere near equally distributed. But look what I can do. And this is a nice thing. If you bring this grid onto your screen, you can actually lock that track using the lock key on the track header. And you can see now this grid is not editable anymore. I'm not running the risk of moving it by mistake. But now all of my text bullet points, they are still editable. And look, if I move them around, they will snap to my grid. And the second one right here, the third one, you notice they snap to all of these lines, horizontal or vertically, they snap to them, even though the grid is locked. So look at this, perfectly aligned, perfectly distributed bullet points. If I hide this now, look at that, bullet points, very nicely distributed. And you can do this horizontally as well if you need to have, you know, equal distance between things. And this is another thing. I created these assets, these grids, with the possibility to customize them a little bit. So for example, if I have a background that is maybe green, okay, so I have a green background maybe, and this green doesn't work because I can't see it, it's not a problem. You just click on the grid item itself that you added it. And on the right side here, using the quick properties, you can change the color. So let's suppose I want to have a blue grid or a red grid, you know, purple, whatever color that is, orange. any color you like, you can change it. And if it's hard to see, by the way, you can also change the thickness of the lines so that they are more visible. And the snapping works just as well. So I have got more grids in here that you can use. For example, you've got a 4x4 grid. There you go. You just place it onto your canvas, onto your timeline. It will align perfectly to the canvas. It's made to be full HD format, 16x9. And the distance between the lines is equal on all of them. So you've got 4x4, 3x3, 2x2, safe margin grid. And I'm thinking of other grids to add in this collection. And if you do go ahead and buy these, you'll get all of the ones that you see in here, and you would help support my work. They're not expensive, but they save you a lot of time. Of course, you can build them yourself if you like. It's nothing special in there. You can build them and you customize them and you add them to your library and you can reuse them over and over. And I'm actually thinking of creating more grids. If you have any ideas for different grids or, you know, different alignments or divisions of the screen that you use, I'm also thinking of adding maybe the golden ratio, for example, for having, you know, that particular division of the screen with the different sectors that are natural and pleasing to the eye. So lots of ideas there. I mean, this is saving me a lot of time right now because I no longer have to guess, you know, the distance between the elements. And hey, you know, if TechSmith adds grids and alignment and snapping and guides to the new version of Camtasia, that would be fantastic. But until then, this is greatly useful for me in all my work. So I do hope you enjoy these. I hope you like them and you find them useful. And if you would like to get them, there's a link in the description there. And thanks very much for your support. And I will see you on the next video.